Sup Shredders, my name is Logan aka Spiderhands, and welcome to Nispy Patrons video for Wenhao. We're going to be reviewing a track from an act named Faye Wong called Bohemian Rhapsody, and if we switch over to here we have it on Bilibili. If I am not mistaken, I believe this could be a cover of the original song by Queen. I'm not sure, we're obviously going to find out, so we're going to listen through this track from start to finish. I think, oh, it does that. Thank you. How do I turn that stuff off again? Let's go. Let's do this. Thanks to Wenhao as well for your request for this month. Okay, cool. I can vibe with this. It's a ballsy move, doing a cover of the song, you know. It's very difficult to pull off, so it'll be interesting to see how Faye Wong does it, but it's good so far. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I mean, she's nailing hit the main lead, the lead vocals. Oh, nice lift there. Very faithful to the original. I think it's in a different key signature just to match Faye Wong's vocal range, but it's very well done so far. Mama, just kill the man. Put a gun against his head. Pull my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun. Nice to have the guitars coming in here. Okay, cool. Yeah, no, the pronunciation is good. The words coming through nice and clearly. The vocal melody, again, is faithful to the original. It's got a similar cadence and a similar emotive feel to it. I dig it. You know, Faye Wong is selling it. Faye Wong is selling Bohemian Rhapsody. And, you know, I've heard covers of it over the years, like from Kanye West and stuff, who arguably did not do it the least bit of justice. But I think that Faye Wong is very respectful to the source material here. And, yeah, I can instantly recognize it. But she's also putting her own spin on it as well, which is cool. Like, you could easily tell the difference between this and the original, and more than just the way of her voice. The drums are really punchy, aren't they? Nice reverb tail on them though. That sent chills up my spine. Although, I think it's more because, like, I understand what Freddie Mercury was going through at that point in time. Nice work in the backing vocals coming here. It's so disappointing when they don't allow more of a spotlight on the lead instrumentalist. I know that Faye Wong is the focal point here, but she's literally just kind of vibing whilst the guitar playing is going. You could totally have the camera. This isn't to Faye Wong, this is the production team behind the recording of this video, you know? Thank you. Don't you swing away from it. Oh, I suppose it's okay to go to the grand stage. But I have massive issues with it. Because in a song like this, it isn't just Faye Wong or Freddie Mercury that makes it special. It's the combination of all the instrumentalists. And for me, I get how big Faye Wong is. It's a shame to me, though, that a lot of the other instrumentalists are in the dark. You know, they're literally shadows. You know, you can't really see them. And it's not something that you have often in a lot of the music that I watch nowadays. Like the videos or live performances, like from like a lot of the Western artists that I listen to, usually you have the whole band on display, even if it's like just an accompaniment, you know. Whereas with a lot of the stuff from places like that we've been doing with these SP Patrons videos for musicians like Eason Chan and Faye Wong and such, they put the other musicians in the dark, and it's just a shame. They deserve almost equal recognition as Faye Wong, in my opinion. With a song like this, where like the accompaniment is so important. And it's so sweet, so weird to me, because I have the vocalists on display here. You can see them individually. It's like the production team only and the lighting team only think that the vocalists matter. Aside from that one guitar solo where it would have been disgusting if they hadn't shown the guitarist at that point. Because it's a friggin' opera, you know. I get that the vocal focus, but like a rock opera. I swear to God, if they do not lift that fucking shadow up, and if they do not show the rest of the band... Oh, dude, I'm gonna throw something in a minute. I get it. I get that they want to show Faye Wong off. And people will be watching us going, Logan, why aren't you listening to the vocal performance? Dude, I fucking spend my life over the last couple of years listening to the vocal performances. I'm not, like, upset because... I just don't get it. I just don't get it. Why does it have to be all dark and shit? Why does it have to be... Why is the lighting only on the front part of the stage? It's... Maybe it's just because I'm more familiar with the original material and, like... I mean... Faye Wong's doing a fantastic job. You know, she's selling it. She's hitting those notes well, but a vocal fry there. They had one shot of the drummer for a drum fill. I mean, at least it's better than nothing, right? Maybe it's just the angle of the camera work we've had where we can't see. Maybe the other musicians are visible. I can't fucking see them, can you? Okay, we've got a little bit of the hi-hat show on there. That's great. Friggin' spotlight shimmered off of the copper. I mean, this musicianship is exemplary. It's friggin' incredible. The performance from the bassist, the drummers, the piano, everything is stunning. It's so stunning to me what they've managed to do in addition to what Faye Wong has had. The highlight of this performance for me has not been Faye Wong. It's been Faye Wong and everything else. She's a great singer, and I think she did a fantastic job of covering this song. It's just bittersweet for me personally as a music reviewer because I tend to look at the whole picture, you know? Cool, that's a somber moment. See, that's great. Now, I know that I'm harping on about this. The lighting in this part makes sense because it's just her. And she's talking about herself. So for the lighting to be on her in this part is great. And I love that. But in that part where all the rest of the instruments came in, they should have lit up the entire stage. They should have lit up the entire thing. And I'm actually angry about it, dude. It's this, yeah, you know, you already know, I'm not gonna repeat myself. And she's just done. And where is the rest of the stage in this part? They could have had the whole thing light up for this end part and shown everyone else who put work in. They could have done that, but they didn't. And she's having a great time, and she's awesome. I love what Faye Wong's done with this. That was rock. That was rock. But I swear to God, man, I'm so furious about this. I don't usually get this angry during a review, but I think it's better for me to be honest when I feel things, and especially when they're relevant to the actual experience of someone watching a live performance. Thank you, first of all, before I go to this next part. I enjoyed the song. Now, I know I've complained a bit in this review about stuff not related to it, but to be fair, I suppose you could argue that if we're watching a live performance, that's part of the experience, is what you see. You're literally watching a video. You're watching people play, and you're also hearing people play. The audiovisual experience is important. I think it's someone who is just struggling so much in life that maybe they shot a man, or maybe they weren't going to live that down, and maybe he was going to go burn in hell or something like that. I'm not quite sure what Bohemian Rhapsody is about. It's someone who's becoming gradually more and more disfigured, and they're tumbling headfirst into hell. That's my understanding of it. And then maybe it comes down to nothing really matters. Nothing really matters to me, with them just eventually realizing, oh, this is nothing is meaningful, and my life is just empty and a void. After all the drama of like the cascading choir and the guitar solos and the bass and the drums and piano and everything else. Did a fantastic job of singing it. She sung the right notes within the key signature that they arranged this for. Lovely bits of vocal ornamentation. Great work as well to the backing vocals, and I'm glad that we did see them sometimes. And I know you're probably sick about it, but I'm going to talk about it. I'm glad that we got to see the backing vocals. This song would not have been as good. This cover would not have been as good without those backing vocalists. Faye Wong could not have done it without them. So I'm really glad that they showed the other backing vocalists in this track, you know, because this is, of course, a conclusion, if I haven't stated it already. So she sung it well. Faye Wong sung it well, you know, changed her approach in certain parts for quieter and louder bits. Great change there, great flexibility there in regards to the dynamics of it. The structure was Bohemian Rhapsody. There's nothing really more to say about that. It was a rock opera, one of the first of its time as I understand it. It was revolutionary and it's an absolute masterpiece. The instrumental performances are top notch. There was not a note out of place, and it's why it is so disgusting to me that they hid them behind that cloud there. You know, that darkness. I hid the other backing musicians in the darkness. The thing, and I know that it's not fair to compare it, the thing that it reminds me of is back in the 20s, 30s, and 40s in the States, where they used to have this massive swing scene, but they used to hide the backing musicians behind a veil so that they couldn't be seen. So you'd literally just have the vocalist in the center, and it'd just be magic that there was backing to it. And I get that Faye Wong is that interesting, and I get that people are going to watch Faye Wong, but it gives me the shits when I see people like, and it's not Faye Wong, I know it's not Faye Wong, I know she's not responsible for it, but the lighting team, the people who produced the video or the lighting for that concert need to understand that Faye Wong couldn't have played that track without them. Not that kind of track. I get it if it's just some friggin' pieced together hastily theme with a few instruments and a drum loop, but that is a friggin' work of art. And the fact that those live musicians did not get more recognition is abhorrent. It's an absolute tragedy. I doubt any of them will watch this, but I want those musicians to know that it was bullshit that you didn't get seen. It's disgusting. I've said disgusting. It's just, that was so good. That was just so good. It makes me really sad. And angry. Makes me sad and angry. I don't get angry often through these reviews. In fact, I can't remember getting angry at a piece of music since the start of the year. But apparently, this is the one where I got angry. And again, final note, this is not Wenhao's fault. I didn't know going into this that this was like this. I suppose I've seen enough of these live performances with a similar behavior where they cut keep the instrumentalists behind a curtain. It's just poor, man. It's just shit. It's lame, dude. But anyways, moving on. The production, recording, mixing, mastering was sensational. absolutely, it was an ambitious arrangement there. They got all those different vocalists, all the different musicians and faders sort of blend together in a mix well, nicely glued, no complaints whatsoever. Beautiful stuff. Yeah. That's my review of Faye Wong's cover of Bohemian Rhapsody for the CSP Patrons video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. If you did, please do go show Faye Wong some love via their various social medias. And they might be on Billy, I'm not sure. And also, go show Queen some love. You know, go show Queen some love, as they are all the creators of the original. And stay cool and stay safe, and please remember to support your local musicians and artists at this point in time, as either help more than ever with all the crazy stuff going on. I'll catch you in the next review. Spiderhands Out!